Shapes. Hello children. Today we will learn how to identify the shapes of objects around us. In the fourth grade, you all have learned about making patterns with different shapes. Can you tell me which shape has been used to create this pattern? If you wish, you can pause the video here and think. Yes, you identified it right, children. This pattern is made of squares. So, children, can you identify shapes of objects around you just like this? Come, let's go to my class. Today, I'm going to discuss with the students some interesting facts related to shapes. Students, so can you identify the shape of this blackboard? If you observe this blackboard carefully and trace the four sides of the blackboard with the help of a chalk on the wall, which shape will you get? You can see that the length of the trace figure is same and the width is also same. So this is a rectangle. A rectangle is a shape which has four sides and the length of its opposite sides are the same. Now tell me, which shape shall we get by tracing this map?
This is a square.
Very good, Ravi. A square is a shape that has four sides. And all four sides are of same length. Now tell me that if we trace this bangle on a paper, then which shape shall we get?
This is a circle.
Absolutely right. Because this is a round shape, in which the distance from the center point to its circumference is the same. So, it's a circle. Now tell me, what is the shape of the upper surface of this pencil? If we paint this upper surface and trace it on a paper, then which shape shall we get?
Teacher, we will get the shape of a hexagon.
Absolutely right. Hexagon has six sides that are joined this way. Students, all of you must have seen such a flag.
Yes, teacher, I have seen such a flag in a fair. The shape of the cloth of this flag is like a triangle.
You identified it right, Priya. Triangle is a shape that has three sides that are joined like this. Summary. So children, today we have learned that if we observe an object carefully, then we can easily identify its shape. Now all of you find shapes hidden in the objects at your home. Thank you. Shapes. Hello children. Do you remember that in the previous video, I taught you to recognize the shapes of the objects? Today I will teach you to draw pictures of objects with the help of different shapes. Come, let's see what Ravi and Priya are making in their books.
Teacher, if we want to draw a tree, then which are the shapes should be used?
A tree can be made by joining the circle and rectangle. First, we will make the trunk of the tree with a rectangle. Then, we will make 8 small circles like this. Now, if we join the outer boundary of this shape and erase all the other lines, then it will become the upper part of the tree. So, isn't it correct? Come on, now draw a kite.
I love flying a kite. If we join 4 triangles together, then a kite will be formed.
Absolutely right, Ravi.
Teacher, now let us draw a heart.
Hey, that is very easy. The front part of the hut's roof can be made with a triangle and the side wall of its roof with a square. And then we will use square to make the walls of the hut, something like this. See, here is the picture. Yes, one more thing. We can also make the walls of the hut with a rectangle, something like this. Children, do you know how does a star look like? Would you like to draw a picture of a star?
Yes, teacher. Every night I watch the stars in the sky. But what is their shape, teacher?
See, Priya, to make a star, first of all, you need to make a pentagon. Now make a triangle on each of its edges. you have to make 5 triangles like this. And see, we have formed a star. Come on, now look at this painting. Whose picture is this?
This is a boat, teacher.
I know how to draw it. If we look at the lower part of the boat, from the middle it looks like a rectangle. If we make 1 triangle each at both the edges of the rectangle, then the lower part of the boat would be complete. Now we will draw a line to make its upper part and we'll make a big triangle on its left side and a small triangle on its right side. How do you find my boat?
Oh wow, the boat is made by just using the shape of rectangle and triangle.
Summary. So children, did you all see how easily Ravi and Priya drew objects with the help of shapes? I hope you have also learned to draw these objects. In the next video, we will learn to draw some interesting objects by joining 3 or more shapes. Thank you. Today we will learn to draw some interesting objects by joining 3 or more shapes. So come on, let's go to the class. Children, tell me which is your favorite cartoon character.
My favorite cartoon character is Mickey Mouse.
So come on, now tell me with which shape you can draw the character Mickey Mouse.
It can be drawn by joining 6 circles. Its big face can be made with 1 circle, 2 circles for its ears, 2 circles for its eyes, and 1 circle for its nose.
Absolutely correct. Now tell me, can anyone of you draw the picture of a cat?
Yes, teacher, I will try to do that. First of all, its eyes and face are made from 3 circles. Then its tail and 4 legs can be made with 6 rectangles. Now its ears, nose and upper part of its tail can be made with 4 triangles. At the end, its claws from 4 squares. See, the cat is drawn. Teacher, is it correct?
Very good, Priya. This is a very interesting drawing. All of you must have seen the train. So come on, today let's draw its engine with the help of rectangle, circle, triangle and square. If you want, then you can pause the video over here and think. See this. Its wheels are like a circle and its chimney is made of 2 rectangles. Rectangle to draw the whole engine and 1 window in the shape of a square. So how was it, children? Can you tell me the total number of rectangles, squares, triangles and circles in this picture? You can seek help from your friends and teachers. So children, did you see that how we drew different objects by joining 3 or more shapes? Now you also draw various beautiful pictures with the help of these shapes. Thank you.
Hello friends, in this video, we will find the angles hidden in objects around us with Dholu and Bholu. Dholu and Bholu's summer vacations have started. They are going for a trip in their car with their parents. Both of them were both sitting in the back seat. Just then Dholu had an idea.
Bholu, I am getting bored sitting in the car. Come, let us play something.
Dholu, why not play a game of find the angle?
Okay, Bholu, look at that sign. It has 1 angle, which is a right angle.
Yes, Dholu, you are right. But if you look carefully, there are 2 right angles here, not 1.
Yes, Bholu, you are right. And look at this car. This too has many angles.
Come, let us find the angles in it. Are you ready? Yes, Dholu, you are right. In the back window, there is an angle which is smaller than a right angle. Hey, Bholu, how can you say this is smaller than a right angle? Because, Dholu, this angle is not like L. Remember, right angles look like L. Yes, I remember. Let's come back to the car. In the front window, I can see an angle which is equal to a right angle. And between the front part of the car and the front glass, there is an angle which is larger than a right angle.
You can stop this video and try to find out more angles here. They all stop in a hotel for the night. From the window of their room, Dholu and Bholu see a traffic sign on the other side of the road.
Bholu, just look at this sign. This too has some angles. Yes, Dholu, you are right.
Children, you must be tired. Go to bed now. We have to wake up early tomorrow.
Sure, Papa. We will sleep in some time. Bholu, did you notice that sign? It has only four angles. 1, 2, 3, and 4. All these are similar to a right angle. Yes, Dholu, there are four angles here, but I can see three more angles. Look at them too. 1, 2, and 3. Oh yes, I didn't notice them. In this shape, there are three more angles, and the value of these three angles are less than right angles.
Children, can you find more angles in this sign?
Dholu, let us go to bed now. We have to wake up early tomorrow. All right, Bholu. Hey, I can see angles in this fan too. Dholu, it is very late now. We will talk about this tomorrow.
In today's video, we have learned how to find different angles in objects around us. In the next video, let us see how Dholu and Bholu find angles in the fan. Thank you.
Hello friends, in this video, we will learn to recognize angles formed in some objects around us. Dholu and Bholu went out on a trip with their mother and father and reached a camp.
Dholu, what are you thinking?
I can see a shape being formed in this tent. Can you identify it?
Children, can you see any shape in this tent?
Oh yes, Dholu. A triangle is being formed here. And all its angles are smaller than a right angle.
Dholu and Bholu, you both have learned a lot about angles. Come, now let's spread this mat and have our breakfast.
Dad, I can see angles in this too.
You both managed to find an angle everywhere.
Yes, Dad. We find it interesting.
Children, do you see angles in this mat?
Yes, Dholu, and they are right angles.
After having breakfast, Dholu and Bholu go for a walk.
Dholu, angles are so important. Angles are everywhere. The nature also forms several angles. For example, have a look at this tree.
Children, can you tell where is the angle being formed on this tree?
Yes.
You identified it correctly. The angle is being formed in this way.
I am very tired, Bholu. Come, let's go to a good place and rest for a while.
Yes, let's go and sit beside the lake.
Hey, Bholu, I can see angles here too.
Where, Dholu? Here there are some trees, water, a boat and some birds.
Dear children, do you also see some angles here? Dholu and Bholu will answer this question in the next video. So far, we searched for angles seen in different objects in the camp with Dholu and Bholu and saw that angles are found in almost every object. Let's meet in the next video. Thank you. Hello friends, welcome to this video. When Dholu asked Bholu, Bholu started looking for angles. Let's see where all Bholu could find angles.
Bholu, I have found an angle. Look at the beak of this bird. It is forming an angle smaller than a right angle.
Wow Dholu, you identified it correctly. And look at this bird, an angle is being formed in its beak too.
Yes, Bholu, and this angle is bigger than a right angle. Bholu, I can see an angle being formed on the tree too. Can you see it?
Yes, Dholu, I also got it. Look at this.
Wow, Bholu, you identified it correctly.
Hey, Dholu, see how good the wind is. It is so much fun.
Yes, Bholu, but it is too late now. Come, let's go back to Dad.
Hey children, where were you till now?
Dad, actually, we were sitting beside the lake.
We enjoyed thoroughly.
We found many angles there too.
Children, looks like you both are enjoying this game of identifying angles.
Yes, Dad, but I'm badly missing our pet cat, Tom.
Hey, Bholu, don't be upset. I will help you teach to make a cat like Tom.
Really, Dad? But how? Please tell me.
Have patience, Bholu. I'll just be back.
Seeing Bholu's excitement, his dad brings a yellow square-shaped paper. Children, you can also take a paper and learn from Bholu's dad.
For this, firstly you need to take a square-shaped paper and make a triangle by folding it at the center.
Children, can you find angles here? Yes. You must be seeing three such angles in it.
Now fold the two corners of this triangle like this and make two small triangles. Then you need to fold this top corner inside. Now turn over the paper. Here is the cat's ears. Just make the eyes and mouth and stick it to a wooden stick. Here, our pet cat Tom is now ready.
Thank you, Dad. This was very beautiful. It was fun.
Children, can you two look for angles in Tom's face? On seeing this, Bholu and Dholu became happy and started playing. You can also play with it, and after playing, when you open the paper, you will find that you have made several angles in the paper with your own hands. After this, Dholu and Bholu went out for sightseeing with their parents and found angles in other objects around them. You should also look for angles in objects around you. Thank you.
Hello friends, in the previous video, we have learned what a right angle is, angle less than right angle is, and angle greater than right angle is, along with Reva and Meena. In this video, we will identify all these angles formed in different objects along with Meena and Reva. Reva and Meena reach home after their exercise. Both are very hungry, but their mother needs more time to prepare the breakfast. While waiting for the breakfast, naughty Reva planned to play a game.
Didi, let's play a game. You have to tell two objects where right angles are formed.
Meena looks around the room. That is when she sees the door in front of her. Are there any right angles in this door? Look at this door, Reva. There are so many right angles. And look at this table. If we look at this table from top, it will look like this. Now look at these corners. Right angles are formed here too. Did I identify correctly?
Oh wow, Didi. But can there be any angles less than right angle in this room?
Come on, both of us will find them. Let us see who will find them first. To find the angles less than a right angle, both the sisters being to look around the room. That is when their mother brings a sandwich for them.
I found it.
I too found one, Reva.
First, let me show you the object I found. Here is my toy box. And see, the lid makes an angle less than a right angle.
Oh, wow. But my angle is very tasty, Reva.
How is that, Didi?
Look at this sandwich. It has three angles and all of them are angles less than a right angle.
Yes, this angle is very tasty.
Now we have just one more angle left to find out. Come on, Reva, let us find an angle greater than a right angle.
Didi, I have already found it. Look at that chair. Some of its corners are making angles more than right angle, like this one and this one.
Yes, Reva, I too found two objects with angles more than right angle.
Which objects, Didi?
Look at that flower pot carefully. There are two corners at the bottom of it and both corners are making angles greater than a right angle.
Yes, Didi, but this is only one object. Quickly tell me about the second object.
The other object is very special. I can make any angle as I want with it.
What? Which object is that, Didi?
That object is right in front of you, Reva. This lamp. Can you tell me which angle is formed between these handles?
This angle is greater than a right angle.
Yes, now look at the magic. Meena bent the handle of the lamp and made it look like this and said, "Now tell me, Reva, which angle is this?"
"Hey, this looks like L. That means it is a right angle."
"Yes. Do you want to see the magic again?" Meena bent the handle of the lamp again and made it look like this. Reva gets surprised and says,
"This angle is less than a right angle." Didi, how did you manage to make all three angles here without changing the length of the handles nor its shape?
Oh no, Reva. Do you remember what an angle is? It tells us about the rotation between the lines. That means the length of the lines does not affect the angle.
Oh yes, I forgot about that, Didi.
Angles are very interesting, Reva. Look at these two pictures. Can you tell me what angles are being made in these two pictures?
The angle in the small picture are greater than a right angle. And the angles in the bigger picture are also greater than a right angle.
This shows that the angle has no relation with the size of the object. Isn't it easy? Can you identify different angles in this shape? Here, there are so many angles in one corner. Come on, let us try to identify them. In this video, we have identified right angles, angles less than right angle, and angles greater than right angles among the objects around us along with Reva and Meena. Now, you too can identify these angles around you along with your friends. Thank you. Hello friends, in this video, we will learn about the types of angles. Today, Reva's sister Meena woke her up at 5 o'clock in the morning and took her to the garden to exercise along with her. But naughty Reva had no interest in exercise. She told her Didi,
"Didi, there is no fun in doing exercise."
Then let us make this exercise interesting.
Yes. Tell me how, Didi.
I will tell you, Reva. You just put one of your hands upwards and another straight like this.
Oh no, Didi. Exercise again.
Hey, Reva. Look at my hands carefully. Do you realize that my hands are making an angle?
Angle? But how?
Do you remember what I had told you about the angles? When two lines join at one point, then an angle is formed between them. Suppose my two hands are two lines and my shoulder is the point where these lines are joined, then an angle is formed between my hands.
Oh yes, but Didi, why did you make only this angle?
This is a special angle. Every angle is either more or less than this angle. But the measure of this angle will always remain the same. This is called a right angle. When a vertical line joins a horizontal line, a right angle is formed between them. Got it, Reva?
Hey, Didi, this looks like the letter L. I will also make a right angle.
Very good, Reva. So then tell me whether this is also a right angle? Yes, Reva, this is also a right angle. Here also a vertical line and a horizontal line are joined together.
Okay, this means can angles be formed in any directions?
Yes, Reva.
Didi, are there any other types of angles?
To find the answer to this, you have to make another angle with your hand. First, keep your left hand like this. And keep your right hand just below your nose like this.
Hey, what angle is this?
Look, when we make a right angle, the distance between our hands is like this. To make this angle, we have decreased the distance between the hands. That means this has become an angle less than right angle.
Look, Didi, I have also made an angle less than a right angle.
Very good, Reva. You have made an angle less than a right angle. But can you make an angle greater than right angle?
Didi, if I increase the distance between my hands longer than that of the right angle, will it become an angle greater than a right angle?
Oh wow, Reva, you are absolutely right. This is greater than a right angle.
After that, Reva and Meena have made different angles while doing exercise.
You two can try identifying the angles that can be formed with the hands and legs of your friends while exercising. Meena and Reva finished exercising and were returning back home. On the way back, Meena saw the watering can held by the gardener. She told Reva, "Reva, do you know which angle is made in this water can? You can pause the video if you want and give it some thought. Look here, if we look at this corner carefully, we can see two lines joining together. Tell me whether this is less or greater than a right angle."
"Didi, this is less than the right angle. But if we look below this pipe, we can see an angle here. And I think this is greater than a right angle."
Yes, you identified it correctly, Reva. There is an angle less than a right angle and an angle greater than a right angle in this can. Let us go home. In this video, we have learned about three types of angles. Right angle, angle less than right angle, and angle greater than right angle. Do you want to identify more angles in other objects? Then you need to watch the next video. In the next video, Meena and Reva will identify the angles in many more objects like doors, toy boxes. So let's meet in the next video. Thank you.
And measurement of angles. Hello friends. Today we will learn how to use a divider and how to measure angles with the help of a protractor. Golu and Bholu are identifying the angles in the different pictures given in their picture book. Let's observe the first picture.
Golu, can you tell me the measurement of the angle being formed in the seesaw?
I think it is an angle greater than right angle.
But I think it is an angle smaller than right angle. Come on, let's ask uncle. He can give us the right answer.
To find out the correct answer, both went to their uncle and asked him about the angle being made in the picture of the seesaw. Their uncle showed them a strange object.
Children, do you know what this is? This is called a divider. With its help, we can find out whether an angle is a right angle, greater than a right angle, or smaller than a right angle. Look, kids, you already know that a right angle looks like the letter L. If I make the shape of L
by
bending both the legs of this divider, we can now find if an angle is a right angle or not. Look here. With the help of this divider, we can find out that the angle in this book is right angle.
Oh wow, uncle. So can we identify the angle of the seesaw given in this picture with the help of this divider?
Yes, why not? To identify the angle in this picture, we will place the divider this way. See, the divider was as open as the measurement of the right angle before. Then to measure this angle, we had to slightly reduce the distance between the two sides of the divider. This means that this angle is smaller than a right angle.
But uncle, is there anything that gives us the exact measurement of an angle?
Yes, we do have an instrument like that. It is called a protractor. You can make a protractor yourself if you want.
How do we do that, uncle?
First, take a tracing paper through which we can see across easily. Now make a semicircle, that is half circle, on that paper. Divide that semicircle into two equal parts. You can see that 90 degree and 0 degree angles are being formed here. Now divide both the halves of the semicircle into three equal parts. So there will be a total of 6 parts of the semicircle. Here we divide 90 degrees into 3 equal parts, and hence the measurement of each part will be 30 degrees. And if we count from 0, then this first angle will be 30 degrees, second 60 degrees. Similarly, on adding 30 degrees to each of these angles, the last angle will be 180 degrees. Here, our protractor is ready. Now, if we have to measure an angle, we will place the center point of this protractor at the vertex of the angle. And remember, one line of angle must be placed along the baseline of the protractor. Now, this second line of the angle tells us the correct measurement of the angle.
Oh wow, uncle, can I now make an accurate measurement of the angle of the seesaw with the help of this protractor?
Yes, sure, Bholu. To get the correct measurement of the angle of the seesaw, we will place the protractor above the angle like this. See, the measurement of this angle is slightly less than 90 degrees. Did you see, children? With the help of this protractor, we can easily measure any angle. In your geometry box, you will find a protractor. It has numbers from 0 to 180 on both sides, from right to left and left to right. In this way, we can measure the angle from both sides using the protractor.
In this video, we learned estimation of an angle using a divider and using a protractor to measure angles. Looking at this angle, can you estimate and tell us what is its measurement? Discuss this with your friends. We will tell you the correct answer in the next video. In the next video, we will see some interesting examples related to measurement of angles. Thank you.
Hello friends,
In the previous video, we learned how we can measure angles using a divider and a protractor. In this video, we will see some interesting examples of angle estimation and measurement with the help of a protractor. Today, Golu and Bholu are playing a fun game of identifying angles in each picture. Let us see who can identify the picture with the correct angle. Come on, Bholu, look at this angle and tell how many degrees it measures.
It looks like right angle. That is, its measurement should be 90 degrees. Let us calculate it correctly with the help of a protractor. Oh yeah, this is an angle of 90 degrees.
Oh wow, you were absolutely correct.
Now let me tell you the measurement of the angle of the next picture. This angle looks greater than 90 degrees. But this angle will be lesser than 180 degrees. Let us measure this angle and see. Its measurement is little more than 120 degrees.
Your guess was absolutely right, Golu. It is greater than 90 degrees and lesser than 180 degrees. Now look at this angle, Golu. I think this angle is lesser than 90 degrees.
Do you think Bholu's guess is right? You can just pause the video and think about it.
Yes, look, its measurement is about 60 degrees.
This game is really interesting. Now look at this angle formed inside the clock. Hey, this angle looks so much lesser than 90 degrees.
Not just that, Golu. This angle seems to be lesser than half of 90 degrees. That is 45 degree angle.
Yes, Bholu, look at this. Its measurement is less than 30 degrees.
So did you all see how Golu and Bholu found an interesting game to measure the angle? You should also play this game with your friends and see whether you are able to give all the answers correctly or not. In this video, we saw some interesting examples of angle estimation and measurement with the help of a protractor. Can you tell that which of these two angles is greater? Just think for a while. We will give you the correct answer in the next video. In the next video, we will see some common mistakes associated with angle estimation and measurement with the help of a protractor. Thank you. Hello friends. In the previous video, we saw some interesting examples of identifying angles with Bholu and Golu and measuring angles with the help of a protractor. In this video, we'll see some common mistakes associated with angle identification and measurement. Both Golu and Bholu were trying to solve the same question, but their answers were coming different. According to Bholu, the measurement of this angle is more than 30 degrees. And according to Golu, the measurement of this angle is less than 30 degrees. Both of them went to their uncle to find out whose answer is correct.
Uncle, how can there be two different measurements of the same angle?
This cannot be possible, Golu. Perhaps both of you may not have measured the angle correctly. Can you show me again how you measured the angle?
Golu and Bholu showed their uncle the measurements of the angle. This time Bholu's measurement was more than 30 degrees and Golu's measurement was less than 30 degrees. Can you tell that which answer is correct? If you want, you can pause the video here and think for a while.
Bholu's answer is absolutely correct.
But how is that, uncle?
Look, kids. To measure angles, we need to make sure where the center point of the protractor is placed. This center point has to be placed at the vertex of the angle, and this arm should be aligned with the baseline of the protractor. Only then will our answer be right. So tell me, what is the measurement of this angle now?
It is more than 30 degrees.
Yes, you are right. But if they are not aligned, then our answer will be wrong. Therefore, one always has to take care of the center point and the baseline.
Okay, Uncle, now I understand how to measure an angle accurately.
Come on, kids. Now let me ask you a question. Can you tell which of these angles is greater?
I think the first angle is greater than the second angle.
But I think both these angles are the same.
Look, kids, to guess any angle, we should look carefully at the curve formed between the arms. The greater the distance between the sides of the angle, the greater the angle. If we look at these angles carefully, the distance between their arms looks the same. To find out which angle is greater, let's measure both these angles using a protractor. Look at this. Both the angles are more than 90 degrees and less than 120 degrees and are almost showing the same angle.
It means that both the angles are equal. Thank you, Uncle. Now we'll never make a mistake while identifying the measurement of angles.
In this video, we learned that in order to measure the angle, we need to align the center point of the protractor and the vertex of angle, and the arm of the angle has to be aligned with the baseline of the protractor. We also learned that if we want to find out the estimation of any angle, then we should pay attention to the distance between its arms. While measuring and identifying angles, you must take these points into consideration. Thank you. Angles in closed figures. Hello friends. Today we will learn about the angles that are formed in closed shapes, that is, angles in closed figures. When Reva and her elder sister Meena were sitting in their garden and talking to each other, Meena asked a question to her sister.
Reva, just take a look around. Can you tell me which all objects you see around? Yeah, sister. A table, a chair, a flying blue kite in the sky, and of course, this delicious jalebi in our plate. Yes, Reva. If you look at this chair from front and then from above, then you can see these shapes. Similarly, if you look at this table from above and this kite from front, we will be able to see different shapes. Yes, sister. This plate and these jalebis also have shapes. Yes, Reva. You have identified it correctly. Now, can you tell me which of these things have corners in their shape? Corners? What are corners, sister?
Do you know what are corners?
Look here, Reva. If I join two sticks like this, what appears in between is called a corner. But if I take one stick, there will be two endpoints on it, which means there would be no corner there. That means when two lines meet at a point or cross each other at a point, then a corner is formed there. So, sister, does this mean that corners are only formed in objects like kite, table and a chair? And the shapes of jalebi and plate do not have corners?
Yes, Reva. Do you know that when two lines join along with each other, then only one corner is not formed, but something else is also formed, which is called an angle. Where there is a corner, there is an angle. And this angle is something which is very useful.
Really? How is that, sister?
The angle tells us the extent of rotation between two lines. The more the rotation, the more the angle. Now look here. If I join another stick to these two sticks, then a triangle is formed. Can you tell me now how many corners and how many angles are present?
Sister, from what I understood, three corners are formed here. And since there are three corners, only three angles are formed.
Absolutely right, Reva. Come on, we will form a figure with four sticks of equal length.
So here are your four sticks and here are my four sticks.
Then Meena and Reva formed figures with their sticks and showed it to each other.
Did you see, Reva? There are four corners in our figures and these four angles are formed in four different corners. Still, both have different shapes.
Oh, yes. But why is it so, sister?
Because the angles in both figures are different. Just look here. The angles in your figure are like this. And the angles in my figure are like this. Because of different angles, the shape of figures are also different. So don't you think angles have their own importance?
Yes, sister. Now I got it. If there is a change in the angle, it will result in change in the figure as well.
Perfect, Reva. Come on, let us identify the angles in the figures we have seen around.
Just like Reva and Meena, can you also identify the angles inside the shapes of different objects? In this video, we have learned about corners, angles formed in them, and the angles formed in closed figures. Did you observe that the angles in figures identified by Meena and Reva are closed figures, just like this triangle and rectangle? Do you know what are closed figures? Are angles formed only in closed figures and not in open figures? What do you think about this? Reva and Meena will answer these questions in the next video. In the next video, we will learn about closed and open figures and we will see some interesting examples on angles. Thank you.
Hello friends, in the previous video, we have learned about angles along with Reva and Meena. In this video, we will learn what are open shapes and closed shapes. And we will see an example of creating a new shape by altering the angles of the existing shape. Today, Meena and Reva are making different shapes with the help of wooden sticks. They have made this shape by joining 5 sticks. And they have made these 2 shapes with 6 sticks.
Reva, do you know that this shape made out of 6 sticks is a closed shape? And this is an open shape?
Reva didn't understand what her sister said. So her sister started to draw the shapes on paper.
Look, Reva, if I draw this shape on paper, then this shape ends exactly where I began to draw it. But if I draw this shape, then the point where I'm beginning to draw it is different from the one point where I'm ending it. That's why it is a closed shape and this is an open shape.
Really? I never thought about this, sister.
Look here, Reva. I have made figures of closed and open shapes. Can you classify them into 2 groups?
If you want, you can pause the video here and do the activity.
Yes, you identified correctly. These are closed shapes and these are open shapes. Come on, Reva. Now I will give you 7 sticks. Can you make a closed shape with them?
Yes, sister. Look what I have made.
Very well done, Reva. Did you observe that there are many angles in this shape? Can you identify the angles in this shape?
Sure, sister. I can try. Sister, in my opinion, there are 7 angles in this.
You are absolutely correct, Reva. Now, can you change the angles in this shape and make a new shape?
Reva has made this shape with those 7 sticks. Come on, let us draw the shape on paper. Did you observe that the starting point of this shape and the ending point of this shape are different? That is why this is an open shape. Can you identify the angles which she changed in this shape?
Do you observe that there are different angles in objects around us? For example, this swing, the hands of a clock also makes different angles at different times of the day. In this video, we have learned that if the starting point and the end point of a shape are same, then it is known as closed shape. And if the starting point and the ending point of a shape are different, then it is known as an open shape. And we also saw an example of making a new shape by changing the angles of the shape. Can you tell which of the following shapes are open and which are closed? Which have angles and which do not? Just think. And to find the correct answer, watch the next video. In the next video, we will see some common mistakes that happen during identifying angles. Thank you. Angles in closed figures, common errors. Hello friends, in the previous video we have learned about open and closed shapes and also identified the angles in shapes. In this video, Meena will explain few common mistakes that happen during identifying the angles.
Sister, what are you reading in the newspaper? Come on, let's play a new game.
Meena got an idea of a new game after seeing the letters in the newspaper. She circled some alphabets and asked Reva,
can you separate the open and closed shaped alphabets and identify the different angles in them? Yes, sister, why not? I know to do this now. Here, number 7 and the letter L are open shapes. They have one angle in them. A and O are closed figures. But alphabet A has several angles in it.
Is Reva's answer correct? If you want, you can pause the video here and think for a while.
Reva, you have identified the angles in A correctly. This is not closed shape, but open shape. Really? But how is it, sister? The shape of A is closed from the top.
Look here, Reva. While the alphabet A on a paper, the starting and ending point are different. And hence, it is called an open shape.
And if we draw O on a paper, then the starting and ending points are the same. Hence, it has a closed shape.
Okay, I never thought about it, sister. Never mind, Reva. Come on. Now tell me whether the angles in these two shapes are the same. No, sister. First shape is bigger. So the angle will also be bigger.
Is Reva's answer correct? You can pause the video here if you want and think about it.
No, Reva, both angles are the same.
Angles do not depend on the length of their sides.
They depend on the rotation between the sides. Here, if I increase or decrease the length of the sides, then there will be no change in the angle. But if I increase or decrease the rotation between the sides, then the angle will increase or decrease. So let's place these two shapes on top of each other like this and think again. Do you still believe that both the angles are different?
No, sister. They are exactly the same. Okay, so that means angles do not depend on the length of the sides. Now I have understood this very well, sister.
Meena has made two angles between two lines. Is the angle marked in blue is greater than the angle marked in red? Or both the angles are same? These two angles are the same. Do you know why? Discuss this with your friends and teachers. In this video, we have learned few common mistakes related to identifying angles. You too can draw different figures and identify their angles. Thank you.
Hello friends, In this video, we will learn about the angles formed by the hands of the clock and the unit used to measure these angles. Today is Sunday. That means a holiday for school. But why are Golu and Bholu looking so sad? Let's find it out.
Uncle has not come yet, Bholu. It is already time for his arrival. Yes, Uncle used to come every Sunday exactly at 9 o'clock to meet us. Golu, did you observe one thing? If we look at the hands of the clock, they are making a right angle. Yes, it is a right angle. Are there any other angles in the clock, Bholu?
Golu and Bholu carefully observes the hands of the clock. And then their uncle enters the house.
Hey, why are you looking at the clock so carefully?
Uncle, do the hands of the clock form angles?
Yes, Golu. Now look, it is 9:05 now. If we look at the angle made by these two hands, they are making an angle greater than a right angle. In the same way, when it is 9:05, then they would be making an angle less than a right angle.
But Uncle, just like we measure time in hours and minutes, can we measure angle in the same way?
Yes, Golu, you can. Angles are measured in degrees, just like knowing the minutes or hours. By looking at the clock, we can tell how many degrees the two sides of an angle are making by looking at them. Okay, tell me about the angles you know.
Uncle, we know about three types of angles. Right angle, angles greater than right angle, and angles less than right angle.
Oh, wow! Do you know the measurement of a right angle, children? 90 degrees.
What is meant by 90 degrees, Uncle?
Look, children. When it was 9 o'clock, the hands of the clock were making a right angle. That means the rotation between them was 90 degrees.
Then, Uncle, what will be the angles less than right angle?
Just think. When the right angle is 90 degrees, then what will be the angle less than that?
Uncle, they could be any number of degrees less than 90, such as 30 degrees, 50 degrees or 80 degrees.
Yes, Bholu, you are absolutely correct. Look here, children. The angle in the clock is now 90 degrees. Can you tell me what is the half of 90 degrees?
Half of 90 degrees is 45 degrees.
Yes, this is half of 90 degrees, that is 45 degrees angle. Okay, children, can you tell now what is the double of 90 degrees?
Uncle, double of 90 is 180 degrees.
Absolutely correct, Golu. Now look at this angle, children. This is double of 90 degrees, that is 180 degrees angle.
That means this angle is made by joining 290 degrees?
Yes, Bholu. Children, now you have seen angles of 90 and 180 degrees. Can you tell how many degrees this angle makes by looking at it?
It looks like greater than 90 degrees and less than 180 degrees.
You identified it correctly, Golu. This is an angle of 135 degrees. This is greater than 90 degrees, but less than 180 degrees.
Oh, wow! How easy is it to identify angles in the clock?
Try to guess the measures of the angles formed in the following clocks. In this video, we have learned about the angles formed by the hands of the clock and the unit used to measure angles, that is degree. Can you tell me when the angle of 90 degree is formed in the clock? Think for a while. We will discuss this in detail in the next video. In the next video, we will see some interesting examples of angles formed in the clock. Thank you. Hello friends. In the previous video, we have learned about the angle formed by the hands of the clock along with Golu and Bolu. In this video, we will see some interesting examples related to them.
Bolu, look what I have got. Mom has given me this old clock. Let us play a game. We will create different times in this clock and we should tell which angle is formed by the hands of the clock at that time.
Oh yes, Golu. The one who gives more correct answers will win. See this, I have made 10 minutes past 12 in this clock. This is less than 90 degrees. This angle is less than 90 degrees. But is this angle less than 45 degrees as well?
Angle 45 degree is half of 90 degrees.
That means approximately this much. But this angle is this much. That means this angle is greater than 45 degrees.
Yes, I feel the same, Golu.
Now see this. I have made 4 o'clock. This is greater than 90 degrees, but less than 180 degrees. And look, Golu. Between 90 and 180 comes 135 degrees. Hey, this is also less than 135 degrees.
Yes, you got it right, Bolu. Now can you tell me at what all times the angles of 90 degrees is formed in the clock?
You can pause the video here if you want and think about it.
In my opinion, right angle is made when it is 3 o'clock and 9 o'clock. But I feel that a right angle is also formed when it is 6:15. Come on, let us ask our uncle.
Golu and Bolu went to their uncle and asked him whose answer is correct. After hearing both, uncle said,
Golu's answer is absolutely correct. Right angles form in the clock only when it's 9 o'clock and 3 o'clock, not at 6:15. Look here. Hands of the clock are like this at 6:15. This is not a right angle, but we can consider it almost like right angle.
Oh yes, I haven't thought about it.
Come on children, I will ask you one question now. When it is 12 o'clock, what is the angle formed there?
At 12 o'clock, there is no rotation between the hands. There will be no angle in this case. Because in this angle, there is no rotation. So we can call it as 0 degrees.
Yes, absolutely correct answer, Bolu. When there is no rotation between the sides of an angle, it is called an angle of 0 degrees.
Did you notice how well Golu and Bolu are playing this game? You can also play a game like this with your friends. In this video, we have seen how the angles of 90 and 0 degrees are formed in the clock with the help of some interesting examples. Do you have a clock near you? Can you tell me which all angles are being formed in it? Can you guess how many degrees those angles are of? Then just discuss this with your friends and teacher. In the next video, we will see some more interesting examples related to angles formed in the clock. Thank you. Hello friends. In the previous video, we have seen how the angles of 90 and 0 degrees are formed in the clock with the help of some interesting examples. In this video, we will see some more interesting examples related to the angles and degrees formed in the clock. Today, Golu and Bolu's uncle is taking them to the garden near their house after school. But why did Golu stop at the entrance of the garden? Yes, I think he is looking at the big clock over there.
Look, Golu, this is a very big clock.
Do you remember what we have learned about the angles formed in the clock?
Yes.
Now the time is 2:15. And if we look at the hands of the clock, we can see that they are making an angle less than 90 degrees. Is that correct, Uncle?
Yes, you are absolutely correct, Bholu.
But uncle, this angle looks less than 45 degrees, which is half of 90 degrees.
Yes, Golu, this is less than 45 degrees.
Uncle, is there any angle that is less than 90 degrees and greater than 45 degrees?
Yes, Golu, why not? Just think, when will such an angle be formed in the clock?
If you want, you can pause the video here and think about it.
I will try, uncle. The angle of 90 degrees is made at 3 o'clock and the angle of 45 degrees is half of this angle. That means the angle of 45 degrees is formed approximately between 5 minutes past 3 and 10 minutes past 3. That means the angle greater than 45 degrees and less than 90 degrees is formed at 5 minutes past 3.
Oh wow, Golu. Your guess is absolutely correct. Come on. Now both of you go and play in the garden.
So children, in this video, we have seen some interesting examples related to angles formed in the clock. Now you make 3 clocks in your notebook and mark 3 angles less than 90 degrees in it. Write the time along with it. You can seek the help of your friends and teachers in this activity. Thank you.